This is festive time in Thailand. People both young and old are preparing for the Loy Kratong festival, held on the full moon day of the 12th lunar month each year. It's a time when the people of Thailand have finished their rice harvest.
Loy Kratong is a lovely festival for us, for Thai people, and it is an enjoyable time of year. For Thai people, we believe that we should pay respect to the God who protect the water, because we may do harm or destroy the water in our everyday life.
One of the festival's purposes is to beg forgiveness from the goddess of water for any pollution that may have occurred over the previous year. Loy means to float in the Thai language. Even today, kratongs are made of banana leaves with the stem of the banana tree as its base. The kratongs contain a flower, a candle, and three incense sticks, which are lighted before being placed on the water. Kratongs are believed to be the vessels that are able to carry away sins and bad luck. The people usually make a wish at the same time. Some people believe that if the candle remains burning until the kratong is out of sight, then their wish will come true. The origins of this festival goes back over 700 years to the first Thai capital of Sukhothai in north central Thailand.
In Sukhothai, they arrange the festival in the classic style. I mean, they try to make the festival like the old festival 700 years ago, because they have some story that they can take it from the stone inscription. So they will make the festival more classic, like they don't use the big lamp or the big speaker. They use only the small lamp. If you come into the night time, the atmosphere is look like 700 years ago.
The ancient Hindu Brahmin influences, which have spread across much of Southeast Asia before the arrival of Buddhism, are believed to be at the root of the Loy Kratong tradition. Although it has been adopted as a Buddhist festival, it is in fact of Brahmin origin, in which people offer thanks to the goddess of water, Prame. According to legend, a great philosopher who lived in Sukhothai in the 13th century had a young and graceful daughter called Homage. She was a beautiful woman who was also a clever poetess, a skillful musician, and an artist of great power. When the king came to know about her, he requested her to join her palace entourage, and she became his leading wife. Thus, Homage, a Hindu Brahmin, became the wife of a Buddhist king. On the Katina ceremony day, when Buddhists celebrate the end of the rain's retreat, Homage secretly prepared to perform her own religious rites, and for this purpose, she made a small boat-like structure called a kratong, made of banana leaves. She then loaded it with paddy husk and put incense sticks in it and floated it in the river. The king was highly delighted with the sight and ordered that it should occur annually in honor of the beautiful Homage, which he named for short Loy Kratong. Loy means to send adrift, and kratong means a little basket-like boat containing small flowers and other offerings suitable for water spirits. Though Loy Kratong is not exactly a Buddhist festival, yet the three pillars of Buddhism, the Buddha, his teachings, the Dharma, and his followers, the Sangha, are represented in the leaf cups they float during the festivals.
This float represents the triple gem in Buddhism. The candle illuminates wisdom of the mind. Flower represents the Sangha, the flowers of the Buddha's teachings, and the fragrance of the flowers and incense is an offering to the goodness and kindness of the Buddha. One of the traditions of Loy Kratong is making a prayer and a wish when you float this. So it is a good idea to have the triple gem represented here.
Sure that young people do realize about the importance of Loy Kratong Day, but I thought that they know, and as part of their life, they make Loy Kratong Festival for fun, and but also they still take this time of the year as a good opportunity for them to do apologize to the water God.
The festival's traditions are also giving way to modernization. The students at Bangkok's Chulalongkorn University have decided to use paper and wire instead of traditional banana leaves and bamboo. Yet, these two students say they are making these to thank Mother Nature after it have benefited from the river all year round. And nowadays, even modern fashion magazines give tips on how to make a designer float. Yet, most of the kratongs are with banana leaves and flowers. In the markets, as this one in Sukhothai, the vendors put their traditional skills into good use on this festival occasion to make some extra money. There are also these roadside lantern stalls, which are a common sight throughout the day. Loy Kratong is a festival where both young and old have a lot of fun all over the country. This festival atmosphere was captured at another of Thailand's ancient cities, the historic city of Ayuthaya. While people wait for the sun to go down before floating their lanterns, they are being entertained by street parades like this one.
In history of the Thailand's Loy Kratong is mean a floating candle floating. It's mean like the candle is mean something lighting for the life, and we are pray to the mother of the river. We Thai people believe in the river is the living or living of the people of the Thai people. We do something bad, we do something wrong. In each year, like this year, it's the full moon of the month of 12. We will leave the bad thing to the river. And Mother River will believe, we are believed that can forgive us. This is tradition here. The custom is tradition is a long time, almost about 800 years ago. People have together and, you know, just like a party.
While Loy Kratong may have transformed into a festival of fun, it is in Sukhothai that traditions are still maintained. Opposite the city hall in the modern-day Sukhothai city, officials are here ceremonially placing the royal kratongs, which have been transported all the way from the royal palace in Bangkok, some 450 kilometers away. These floats would be taken in a parade to the historic city, which is about 24 kilometers from here.
This is the remain of the Sukhothai kingdom. The remain of the first capital of Thailand. The remain of the place that is the beginning of the Loy Kratong festival. So all of the Sukhothai people will come to the first place that is the original place that begin the Loy Kratong festival. They join together and celebrate together.
This parade, which depicts local traditional culture of the Sukhothai region and brings in the royal kratongs to the festival grounds, involves a lot of young men, women and children.
Young people, they go to work at the life field, have the opportunity to meet together only in the festival. And because mostly they go out to work in the farm, go for the farming. So in the Loy Kratong festival, they come together and make the kratong together and float at the festival. So this is the opportunity for the Thai teenager or the Thai young people to meet together to have the whatever activity together.
To keep the traditions flowing into future generations, it is important to get the young people involved in the preparations for the festival. Thai educational authorities thus encourage schools to take part in a kratong making competition, for which special awards are given at regional level. These kratongs exhibited at the Sukhothai Historic Park are the award winners, some of which have been made with rice. These are kom pat, or spinning lanterns, exhibited here at the festival park. These revolve using the heat generated by a candle. This type of lantern, which needs considerable skill to make, has a double cover, and when the lantern spins, the shadow of the design on the inner cover appears on the outer cover. It is part of the Loy Kratong tradition here to pay your respects to King Ramkamhaeng the Great's monument at the historic park. They make offerings of betel leaves, flowers and incense. The kom loy, or hot air balloon, is part and parcel of the Loy Kratong festival today. Built in a variety of shapes and sizes, they are released into the sky during the night. These are made of sheets of light-colored paper, glued into a cylindrical or cubic shape and attached to a loop of sliced bamboo. It is believed that releasing a kom loy wards off bad luck. After the reenactment of origins of this festival, shown earlier, is complete, we come to the final part of the Sukhothai's celebrations, the ceremonial floating of the royal kratongs.